Hello, this is Jeremy from AltRider, and we're going to do the installation of the Adventure 2 foot pegs for the Africa Twin. This will fit for both the Standard or the Adventure Sports. This is a fairly easy installation. Let's take a look first at what you get in your kit contents. So you'll get your box, and then inside of your box, you're going to have both your fit kits, your cleats. These are custom cleats that are just the right amount of traction while not damaging your boot. Believe it or not, we spent a lot of time to get that dialed in to get the perfect relationship there. And then you'll get your peg bodies that we've then got to go ahead and fit up the studs on those. Taking a look at the fit kit, which is what's going to make our system work, we're going to get our spacer bodies. We're going to get a lower spacer, long, tall spacer. And this system is what allows us to do a high and a low position on the foot peg. We're going to go ahead and show that shortly. Then you get the two socket head cap screws and four sets of washers. You've got fine and medium, and that way gives you the perfect ability to dial in the camber of your peg. And so that series of standard and skinny washers allows you to really just dial in this camber, and that allows to hold your feet towards centerline of bike. And then we've got replacement cotter pins for the final assembly. And then we've got the spring bodies that are right and left, but we'll show you how you use them inversely when we raise and lower the different foot peg bodies. And then the tools I'll need is just a 5mm socket driver, and this is just for putting the peg bodies in, and either a pair of pliers or side cutters for pulling and then resetting the cotter pin. And then if you buy directly from AltRider, you're going to get a bottle of resealable Loctite for the assembly of the foot peg. You can see the significant upgrade from the factory peg to the Adventure 2 AltRider pegs. The AltRider pegs will be more comfortable and offer more grip without getting in the way. Let's go to the underside of the foot peg body, guys, and you're going to want to orient your cotter pin. Get this guy so that you can flatten him out and drive your cotter pin. You know, there's a trick here, guys, with the cotter pins with a pair of side cutters that you can use if you want to salvage it. If we're just clipping it off, which you can do as well, but the side cutters will actually leverage in to the soft steel of the cotter pin and help you actually pull it through, because it's always going to be just bent a little bit and doesn't want to come right out. Make sure that you capture and pay attention to the retaining washer. The Africa Twin ones are really easy to do, so it's easy to pull that pin out. And now I've got my OEM spring and peg, which I won't reuse, but I'm going to reuse the pin and the washer. To install the cleats on the foot peg, add some thread locker to each cleat or hole, get them started by hand, and then tighten to 7 Newton meters or 5 foot-pounds with a 5mm socket. Here's a set of silver pegs, and really straightforward to figure out orientation, but if you need any help, the AltRider logo goes forward facing. So I'm gonna grab my rider's right-hand side foot peg and then get my spacer body set up. I'm gonna just show you guys this installation, but I'm also gonna show you in the high and then the low position. So you guys can see it, this is the difference. So that's in the low position, tall position. The difference is 12 millimeters of change, and so, or a half of an inch. You guys can decide if you want to put your pegs lower or taller. So let's get started. I already went ahead and torqued down all of my studs with the 5mm and my thread locker, but now I need to set my camber. If I put my screw in with zero washers, that's gonna be dead neutral, meaning exactly parallel with ground. I wanna just get a slight amount, so I'm gonna go with one skinny washer and one thick washer. I cue up my camber bolt, and I just put my washers on first so I don't knock off the Loctite. The smaller screw of this nature, we just need one or two drops. Get this guy in here. I'm gonna use my number 5 Allen key on a driver. I'm gonna go ahead and drive that in and then torque that. I'm gonna explain the fit kit for the low position first, and then we'll invert it and show it for the high position. In order to go into the low position, it'll help you before you get started to go ahead and orient your two spacers just like this to make it easiest at home. The tall spacers and the short spacers are exactly the same. Of course, the springs are different, why you have a gold and a silver. and your wedges are different. Now that we've got them oriented, it's the camber bolt will always touch the wedge on this plane and make it easiest. And because I want to be on the low position, that means my spring body is going to be on the top. That's what puts the peg on the bottom. And so then do my wedge. There it is, touching the camber bolt, just like we talked about. It makes it easier. You feed your spring in. It's got the long tang, silver for low on rider's right-hand side. And then I put my short spacer body in on the spring. And now we can take this assembly over to the bike. Here's our assembly. Silver for peg low on rider's right-hand side. It would be the inverse if we want to do the peg body in the high position. We'll have the wedge body on the bottom and we'd be on the gold spring. But so let's go ahead and install this on the low position. I'm gonna grab my OEM pivot pin and the washer. I wanna bring my wedge body in, making sure that my spring sits up on the clevis. I wanna make sure that my bushing is able to drop in, and then all I've gotta do is push down. These springs are actually quite easy to overcome, unlike some of the other motorcycles, and now I've got this guy oriented correctly. And then, to do final installation, I put my washer and my cotter pin. Go ahead and bend my cotter pin up, but let's actually take this guy apart again now, and we'll put him in the high position. So we'll go back over to the table, but we'll take this guy out, just like we did with the factory. We're gonna trade, and now we're gonna go to the bottom. So now we're gonna put the spring on the bottom, which now puts us in the high position. We're gonna trade out for this wedge, the other wedge, and remember, we always wanna see it that plane touching the camber screw. Now I get ready for my spring. I've now switched to the gold spring. Get my spring in first, set my small spacer. Let's go back over to the bike. Here we are again with the wedge on the camber bolt, and we're gonna come back into it. Again, making sure that my bushing drops in. There's my spring catch and my OEM peg pin. And then again, guys, pretty easy to overcome this spring. It's, you don't even need an awl. And then I set that in there, and now I'm good to go. And then I've got my OEM washer and the cotter pin. And then we'll just bend those back, and that's your installation. And then I want to turn that, and I want to get that guy tucked up in there. Being a hollow pin, I can actually grab a hold of it. And there we are. And then, of course, you guys are gonna repeat the same thing for the other side, making that decision if you wanna be in that upper position or the lower position, selecting your camber, and that's all there is for the installation. If you guys have any questions, please feel free to reach out to us. Again, we're really proud about the investment we make in our customer service, and or if you have any needs or you misplaced anything or need any of your hardware serviced, let us know.